Got a lot of traffic out here at Springhill today. There's two airplanes in the pattern. Not something you see very often out here. Touch and go practice. So what this...
1653 left final for 1-8.
Left final for 1-8, okay. Must be a new guy. Anyway, what I'm about to do is fellow pilot.
Traffic Skyline 357 Hotel Tango left downwind runway 18. Touch and go Springhill.
Yeah, these boys is jamming together. What I'm gonna do is unbox a glider and do a test flight on it, and I'm gonna do a brake line adjustment. This guy Nick Shepler, he's bought a Universal 1.1 and he wants me to test it out before I ship it to him. Always happy to oblige. I thought we just might make a video about the whole process. Funky. Winds are about, I don't know, 5 gusts and 10 out of the southeast. Two planes in traffic pattern. Got a student coming out here in an hour. The temperature is right at 60 degrees. So cool, not cold. Like the I'm probably gonna go over to the Muddy Bottoms. They're having like a four-wheeler ride over there and just do some maneuvering around the lake out there and wave at those guys. Let's go get to it. Let's break out some gliders. So I'm gonna do a little change of plans, Nick. I'm not gonna fly that Universal 25.5 because the wind is a lot stronger than what they were predicting. It's gusty, it's thermally, which, you know, I'm trying to go kind of into the wind. I need to penetrate. I got myself in a bit of a situation previously by selecting the wrong wing for the day. And that's kind of what's happening again here. I don't want to select the wrong wing for the mission. I'm going to break out this Hadron XX22. That's going to give me the speed and penetration needed. Something else I do. I put a lot of extra fuel in the tank, like more so than what I usually would need, just for added weight. The weight gives me speed, stability on the glider. It loads it up. You want that in punchy conditions to prevent things from going crazy. Yeah, wind's just whipping all around. I hear it like ticking the windsock and stuff. So yeah, strong wind conditions. That's what it is. Strong wind requires a faster glider. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to set this thing up. I'll see you guys over here in a second. So back to the video that I was trying to make yesterday when it was nasty. Today, it is not nasty. It's actually quite nice. I am going to shorten the lines on this glider and do a test flight for Nick. He asked me to do that. Also told him I'd make a video. He said he was cool with that too. So I got my little clippers. That's all you really need for a new wing unboxing. Let's go look at that now. Hey, there's my jacket I was looking for. Okay, nice. And that's somebody else's. This is the one we're looking for. Unopened wing. So traditionally speaking, usually I wouldn't do this, but I've opened enough of these wings to know that the brake lines are set pretty long. Now, this is shooting myself in the foot here. I should probably open the wing all the way, go do a little kiting with it, and then I would know 100%. But I'm just gonna roll the dice and say that they're gonna need to be shortened about 3 to 4 inches. We'll go ahead and throw 4 on there and see how that feels. Then I'll go kite the glider. We'll know what we're looking at then. It's the way we're gonna do it today. So all you really need to do a brake line length adjustment is a marker. We're gonna mark on both lines where we wanna tie the new length at, and then we're gonna loosen the knot, move it a little further up, and then retie it in that exact spot. Watch how I do it.
What's that?
It's a Dudek Universal 1.1.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I got to shorten the brake lines for a customer and then send it to him. But he wants me to test fly it, too.
No, hey, no problem, Rob.
Yeah, I got that covered.
Can you free fly with this?
Oh, of course.
You'd rather have that or a Roadster 3?
Oh, this one. Looks good enough to me. That one will go there. This one will go here. And that's as simple as it is. The little pouches are kind of fiddly, but overall it's not that big of a deal because you're not doing this stuff all the time. You know, you're setting your brake line lengths where you want them initially, maybe one more adjustment after that. If you don't have the little pouches, what I quite often do is just roll up the excess and put a zip tie around it. Zip it up. You don't have to worry about the little loose ends going into the propeller and getting sucked in. I've seen that cause accidents, so it's important to manage the little length of line that's left. You never cut it off, because you may have to lengthen it at some point for a different machine, or maybe you're on wheels now. So you never cut that extra line off. You always maintain it somehow. Typically a zip tie is the surefire way. I've never seen one of those let go. I have seen lines come out of these pouches before. Just a FYI heads up on that. But as long as you're doing your pre-flight and checking it before you go, it's usually not that big of a deal. And should it come out, just, you know, sort of grab it and hold on to it while you're flying. And that'll keep it from going back into the danger parts. Let's hook up to this thing and go fly around, see how she flies.
All right, where's that jacket? There she blows. I'm gonna take this brand new ride out here and set her up. See if we can't launch. What's the wind doing? It's blowing. So what we're dealing with here, we have got a Universal 25.5 size by Dudek. We're just gonna unfold it here.
Funky.
I wish I could talk to you about that new glider smell, but my sinus infection has got my smeller all messed up. So I can't even tell, man. But I expect that it smells just like a new paraglider. Oh, look, I got your first grass on the risers, Nick. Hope you're cool with that. Yeah, that one's clear. This one needs to be swooped. One time. All right, first inflation. Let's have at it. All right. Let's get it back into the... Okay, that's in the wind right there. Oh, yeah. Looking good. Everything seems to be connected. Always give a new wing a once over. I know that they're inspected at the factory, but this never hurts. And making sure everything is how I like it. Trims are locked in on a new Universal. It's got different toggle, what do you call that? Media to hold them open. I really prefer to take that out of mine. I'm gonna leave this in since it's not my wing. Everything else is looking good. Tip steers are locked in. That's what that is. If you're gonna tie in 2D or tip steering, that's where you do that. Toggles are good. Everything is proper. Yeah, I'm good with it. All right, so I'm gonna let the motor be warming up as I clip in. Something I do pretty regularly as a efficiency of time type deal. Plus, if it don't start, then you gotta unclip. A couple of practice pulls. All right, clear. Never on the first one. Clear. Nope. Third time's a charm, no matter what I do. So as that's warming up, now I'm gonna clip in. Brapping, baby, brapping. Get the controls in my hand. A's. Everything grabs good, Nick. She's looking good. That seems to be working well. Got some wind. I don't see any traffic. That's what I'm talking about. Let's inflate this beast. little bit off-centered on the wind. Oh, it's coming back down. I'm gonna let her go down. Once they start their way back down, if you'll just go with it, a reinflation is so much easier. These are light wind conditions in between forward and reverse. I just wanted to do reverse so that I could scan the lines and see everything. Let's try it again. I see now that it's good. And get a little speed on it. Did I blow his glider? I don't know, maybe. I've got like full fuel in this thing, so. She looks good, Nick. She turns good to the left. Let's see what she does to the right. Very nice. Let's go up. Up, 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 up. All right, let's throw a couple moves on this thing and see how she handles. Huh, a little left. A little right. Oh, nice. Weight shift left. Pull. Oh, she gets big. And to the right. Also pretty big. Speed. Weight shift. Brake pressure. All right. Woo. She gets big quick, but I'm out of altitude, so I can't go any bigger. Nice. She flies good. I think this may be my favorite size in this wing, at least from my personal weight preferences. This one just flies good. It's big enough to give you plenty of lift, yet it's small enough to be pretty agile. Do a couple of squirrely turns on it, why don't we? Make a horn. Nice hard slalom turn. Again, it's no slalom wing, but you can certainly do the same maneuvers with it. Check our winds, do a nice little touch and go. I'm down with it. Brakes are in a good position for a flare. Nice. A little foot drag action. Woo! Good weight shift authority. Yeah, let's do a little foot drag, why don't we? Nice. Another little landing. Just running along, running along. Foot drag it down here by the gliders. What do you think? Oh, I'm getting lifted and put down. So the thermals are lifting me 5-6 feet. And then they're letting me down. Yep, there it is. So flying low could be sketchy, even on a day like today, when you're being lifted and set down. So I'm gonna go up to about 20 feet and that's gonna be my safe area. I can feel the rotor coming off of the tree line here. Oh yeah, for sure. Look, that wind sock's pointing the wrong way. So definitely turbulence here. And that's why I'm just flying into the rotor of these trees, these buildings, whatever. There's stuff. So I'm gonna go a little higher. Nice glider. Altitude for my downwind run. Ah, Mr. John working good down there. Love it. But Nick Shepler, I deem this wing flight worthy, my friend. You're going to have many wonderful hours with it, I'm sure. Let's see. Come on down. Come on. She don't even want to fall down. She just wants to float there. Ha ha. Set her down gentle for you. No slamming the customer's wings down to the ground. All right. Let's go dump this heavy motor. Okay. So, I got to fold this wing up to ship it. And when you're folding a wing, first thing I want to do is kind of stretch it out and find the center and then get all the lines on the inside of this glider. So we're going to walk over here. And these wings are nice because they have a dot right there at the back center of the glider. You never want to step on lines. Center of the glider, risers right there. Same thing on this other side. Right here. At this point, we're not going to drag it across the ground, but we're going to acquire all these leading edge sails and walk them towards the center. And I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. So once you get the leading edge sort of gathered up here and everything tucked in nice, that's what this little strap is for right here. You'll get one with every wing. I've got a drawer full of them too. I'll use them every time, but if you're by yourself and you're packing a glider, securing all these leading edges across this strap here, it's going to hold everything in place whenever you go to mess around at the other end of the glider here. Buckle that. Again, get all my stuff kind of tucked in where I want it. Make sure you grab it plenty low. And we tighten that up. That'll keep us from pulling this end back out. Now we go back to the other end. So you get here and it's just kind of a game of tug of war. You're gonna pull it. Sort of find that trailing edge. Now as you pull it, you're gonna work your way up toward the glider. Cause all those sails up there are locked in. Again, lines on the inside. This is where it's nice to have like a concertina bag. Oh, look, it looks like Dave joined the party. And as I go, I'm going to put my leg on the glider. Just to keep the air pushed out. Again, the further I go, the more I'm going to squish it down. This is where you push the air out. It'll go out those leading sails at the front. And pushing the air out is probably the biggest hassle with folding a glider. If you can get the air out of it from the end down here all the way to the front, it's going to fold up really nice. And if you have a bunch of bubbles in it and such. See, I got the tips of the glider here. There's that corner, there's that corner. Relatively equal. What up, Dave Hamlin? We're making a video how to fold a wing. Oh, come on. We narrating. Get all the insects off of it. Skeeter halt. So yeah, I'm just pressing it down. Squeezing it in. Tuck everything to the inside. And pushing the air out. Now at this point, I'm going to lay the thing over on its side. And we're going to turn the whole glider kind of sideways and sort of tuck it in on itself. I'm going to push all this stuff to the inside, all the way down the glider till I get to the tip here. So you have something laying on the ground that looks kind of like that. Still need to get some air out of it. We're going to take our little squish bag here. Actually, I'm going to put the risers back in the riser bag. Seems that it's a popular color. Nick Robert got the same taste in wings. All right, so I'm gonna take the riser bag. I'm gonna fold this wing into fourths. So dead nuts in half, and then again, if you bust it out into four sections, that's what we're looking at here. I'm gonna put the risers on this section, and again, pushing the air out. We're going to come up, go across right here. And again, we're going to push the air out of this part that we've made our fold on by pushing it in. Then we're going to take this part and do the same thing. Come back. Again, having that leading edge. So you can take this thing off here now and wrap it around the entire length of the glider. Give yourself some room here and then buckle it down. Then you can tighten it. Make sure not to cinch up any glider. But that holds everything true. And then you've got your leading edge supported. Got the wind blowing, so I'm going to turn it around this way, so that the wind assists me. My little packing bag here. And it should fit down in there nicely. Oh yeah, Dave's fixing to go. We've got this nice backpack here. We're gonna put it down in here and use that to kinda squeeze it down the rest of the way. Lay that there, pull this up. And once you get it in the backpack, you got these cinch straps. You can use those to secure it down even further. squeeze all the air out of it with these. Same thing here. All right, Nick, she's ready to ship, my friend. Congratulations on your shiny new Universal 1.1 size 25 and a half with adjusted toggles and test flight. Yoo-hoo! We'll put it in the box here with all the padding facing up so that we don't risk getting cut with a knife when it gets reopened. All I gotta do is tape it back up and ship it to you, my friend. Okay, good. Hey, hi, guys. Woo! Hope you enjoy it, Nick. I hope you guys like the video. Much love, everybody. Kyle out.